Good morning children, welcome to your GK class. So this video is for class 7 and today we'll be doing page number 12 and 13. Let us improve our English. Okay, so our topic is related to English language today. So let's begin our exercise, children. So this is page number 12, as you can see. Okay, let us improve our English. What are we to do out here is we are going to rectify some mistakes which are given in the sentences. Sometimes when we are speaking English, we make some common mistakes. So out here also these some mistakes are there. We are going to rectify them in the sentences given. Okay, so let's start, children. Now, could you repeat again what you just said? Okay, this is the first sentence, and here in this sentence you can see that repeat and again, both the words repeat and again means same, because repeat also means doing it again and again, and again also means the same. So no need of you using both the words. So what you will do is we can omit this again and we can just write, could you repeat what you just said. So this much is enough. Okay, now number two, children. I do not go swimming because I fear the water. I do not go swimming. Okay, so it doesn't mean anything. So you have to add a word. So for what you are going, isn't it? So you are using, so we have to use a word for. Okay, so you have to write, I do not go for swimming because I fear the water. So you have to add the word for. Okay, now number three, children. All the children did not eat their food. So it doesn't sound very correct. So what do? We will omit the. So we'll write, all children did not eat their food. Okay, so it's not the particular children, so there are many children. So we'll just say all children did not eat their food. This much is enough. Number four, tears rolled down my eyes. Okay, so when you are saying tears roll down my eyes, so it's a simple sentence, so we are not making it past. So we will just write, tears roll me a good advice. So here also you see the sentence sounds correct, but the thing is that your teacher obviously gives you a good advice. It's not that she gives you a bad advice. So she's always giving you good advices. So no need to mention the word good. So my teacher gave me a advice. So that way we are going to cancel this good. We are just going to write, my teacher gave me a advice. Okay, now number six, our principal gave a small speech. So usually speeches are small, and whenever our principal, the head of the department, gives a speech, it's short and sweet every time. So our principal gave a speech, so we don't require this small. Okay, now number seven, children. Let's move to number seven. Can I have some more, please? So when you're asking for a permission, then we usually use may. I have some more, please. So what we will cancel this can and we will use may. Okay, now the last one, number eight, she distributed sweets amidst her friends. So among is a better word than amidst. So what we can do is we can omit this amidst and we can write among. Okay, so we will do this, we will omit amidst and will write among. So the sentence will be, she distributed sweets among her friends, among. Okay, this way we complete rectifying the sentences. Now we are going to the next one, children. Number B, what is the correct meaning of this word? So it is dealing with the vocabulary, it's dealing with the meanings. Tick the correct answer. So we are going to tick the correct answer. curio means an unusual object. Number A. Now we are moving to number 3, palette. You must have heard this word. This is related to drawing and art. And this is the meaning of palette is number B, artist's paint board. So you must have seen a palette. It is round and it has got different shapes in it where you pour in different colors and use it with your painting brush. So this is an artist's paint board. Okay. Now we are moving to our next page, number 13. So here also we have got some words and we are going to take on the correct meanings. Number 4 is shallow, S-A-L-L-O-W, and it means yellowish. Okay, number A, yellowish. So you will tick mark on yellowish. Number 5 is a tiara. Tiara is a crown. It's like a crown. You must have seen girls wearing it with decorated with flowers and all. So this is a crown. Now number C, how good are you at spelling? Here is a little exercise for you to find out. So we are going to just rectify the spellings out here in the sentence given. Do not harass others or embarrass yourself. Embarrass. So here you see the spelling of embarrass is given E-M-B-A-R-R-A-S. Whereas the spelling for embarrass is E-M-B-R-R-A-S. So this is the actual spelling for embarrass. So we are going to use this spelling. Number next one. So let's again read the sentence. Fulfill your ambition to skillfully maneuver the movable yacht conscientiously. Okay. Conscientiously. So the spelling first we are going to correct is of maneuver. Okay, so maneuver spelling out here is given M-A-N-O-U-V-E-R, but the spelling for maneuver will be M-A-N-O-E-U-V-R-E. So the correct spelling for maneuver will be M-A-N-O-E-U-V-R-E. So you are going to write the correct spelling that way. Okay. The movable yacht. Now we are going to correct the spelling of conscientiously. Out here is given C-O-N-C-I-E-N-T-I-O-U-S-L-Y. So the correct spelling as we are going to write will be C-O-N-S-C-I-E-N-T-I-O-U-S-L-Y. This is the correct spelling for conscientiously. Okay. C-O-N-S-C-I-E-N. Why? So this is the correct spelling, thus benefiting all and practice at the center. So rest is all correct, rest all the spellings are correct. So these are the rectifying spellings which you are going to rectify in the words, which you are going to rectify in the sentence, the words. Next we are coming to number D, children. As you know, homophones are words that sound alike but are spelt differently. So homophones are actually sounds which are very similar to each other when you hear it. Okay, but they are spelt differently. They have a different spelling. So here are some clues to homophonic words beginning with V and W. So we are going to complete this words out here with V and W. They begin with V and W and they sound almost same, but their spellings are different. They sound very much alike. Number 1A, a drink made from the juice of grapes. So it is wine. It is called wine, W-I-N-E, wine. And a climbing plant, it is a vine. It is V-I-N-E, vine. So they sound almost same, but the spellings are different. Number 2A, comparative degree of wise is wiser, W-I-S-E-R. And 2B, part of a helmet is a visor, V-I-S-O-R. So when I say wiser and when I say visor, it sounds almost same. But the spellings, you see, they are quite different. Number 3, comparative degree of bad is known as worse, W-O-R-S-E. So we pronounce it as worse. So when you're saying worse and worse, it sounds almost same. Number 4, A, worn under a shirt, it's called a vest. A compass direction is a west, W-E-S-T. The last one, 5, be different means vary, V-A-R-Y, vary. And 5B, be careful means worry, worry, W-O-R-R-Y. So when I say vary and worry, it's almost same. The spellings are different. So with this, we complete this exercise of homophones. Okay, children, so this much only we are going to do today in this chapter related to English grammar. That's the end of it, children. Complete your exercises as is given. Okay, thank you, children.